Your seamster, Bok. He is always eager to see your return. Please, will you talk to him when you can? I'm sure he would be much contented.
Bok the Seamster, at your service, Master. Ready to make adjustments to your garments. Master, my apologies. Your wardrobe includes the garb of the old demigods, and I'm afraid I can't make adjustments to them. My mum told me once that a royal seamster would do them up in a jiffy. Just wait, Master. Before long, I'll be that good too. Going so soon? Please do be safe on your journeys.
It's me, Dielos. Answer me, would you?
Hello, friend. Tell me if you know, would you? The whereabouts of the hidden house of those despicable fiends. The recusants who hunt their fellow tarnished. They laid hands upon my servant Lanya, and I refuse to let the insult stand. The tale of House Hoslow is told in blood. I, Dielos, swear to deliver the message. They laid hands upon my servant Lanya, and I refuse to let the insult stand. The tale of House Hoslow is told in blood. I, Dielos, swear to deliver the message.
you. We don't receive many visitors. I presume you are tarnished? What brings you here? Oh, pardon me. It's hardly my place to ask, is it? I am E.G., a blacksmith who once served the Carian royals. An old codger who refuses to retire his rusty hammer. So here I am, still quietly plying my trade on this spot. Perhaps you'd like a display? These bones are old, but still able. Watch out there. When I'm absorbed in my smithing, I lose sight of all else. If you come too close, I'm apt to cause you harm. I am, after all, terribly large compared to you, tarnished. You don't know how hard it is not to break anything while I work. Brave tarnished. A word of warning, if you please. This territory once belonged to the Carian royal family. Their manor lies not far beyond this point. When the Rhea Lucari Academy turned on the Carians, the Knights of the Cuckoo descended on this tract. After leveling it, they carried on to the manor. The Carians were taken off guard, but their strength had not waned, and they repelled the Knights' onslaught by conjuring an enchanted snare that remains potent to this day. That is why I say, tarnished, don't go near the manor unless you wish to lie with the corpses of the heedless Knights of the Cuckoo. Blythe actually did that, did he? Quite a rare occurrence for such a guarded soul as he. Perhaps he sensed something unusual about you. At any rate, if you're friendly with Blythe, I've something else that might suit you. I've explained the peril of the enchanted snare that remains at the Royal Carian Manor. Whatever you do, brave tarnished, stay away from that death trap.
You're tarnished, aren't you? I welcome you to the Church of Vows. I am Miriel, steward of this sacred chamber. My apologies for the unseemly state of affairs. Do you know the origin of this place? How it came to be known as the Church of Vows? Well, that is a shame. But who can blame you? The shattering has caused us, all of us, to lose sight of something very dear. It is here, at the Church of Vows, that the great houses of the Erd Tree and the Moon were joined by the matrimonial bond between red-haired Radagon and Renala of the Full Moon. And so our church holds in view the monuments of both houses, the Erd Tree of the capital and the Academy of Rhea Lucaria. Oh, was there something you needed? You are free to show yourself around. I would serve as your guide, only my legs aren't what they used to be. If you find anything of use, you are free to take it with you. Unless, perhaps, you are in search of instruction. In which case, I will share all that I know. Oh, what have we here? Very well, let us both learn together. Heresy is not native to the world. It is but a contrivance. All things can be conjoined. Do you possess any celestial dew? Then I would like to share my knowledge with you. Concerning the miracle of this Church of Vows, Radagon once cleansed himself with celestial dew, repented his territorial aggressions, and swore his love to Renala. The order of the Erd Tree and the fate of the Moon were conjoined, and all the wounds of war forgiven. This miracle blesses the Church to this day, and so you need only follow Radagon's example to restore any bond, however strained or severed, to its rightful state of harmony. My faith does not waver. The miracle rooted in these grounds will once again mend the world. And this time, its bounty will not be squandered. If you would be Elden Lord, tarnished, I hope that you too will share my faith. You wish to know more of Lord Radagon? Lord Radagon was a great champion, possessed of flowing red locks. He came to these lands at the head of a great golden host. When he met Lady Renala in battle, he soon repented his territorial aggressions there, and became husband to the Carian Queen. However, when Godfrey, first Elden Lord, was hounded from the lands between, Radagon left Renala to return to the Erd Tree capital, becoming Queen Marika's second husband and King Consort, taking the title of Second Elden Lord. The mystery endures to this day as to why Lord Radagon would cast Lady Renala aside, and moreover, why a mere champion would be chosen for the seat of Elden Lord. You wish to know more of Lady Renala? She is queen, head of the Carian royal family, and governor of the Academy. Great. Sadly, her heart was... And then... In the end, Lady Renala was left alone. Cradling the amber egg, Lord Radagon bequeathed her. Now she devotes herself to it through forbidden rite, the grim art of reincarnation. You would do well to remember, severing a vow, strongest of bonds, has consequences ever more dire. You know, it's said that Lord Radigan harbored a secret. A famed sculptor of the Erdtree capital was once summoned to render Lord Radigan's likeness in giant stature when he glimpsed the skeleton in Radigan's closet. And as such, it's said the great statue harbors his secret too. You know, it's said that Lord Radigan, a famed sculptor, when he glimpsed, and as such, to experience the miracle, kneel in the basin at the back and cleanse yourself with celestial dew. Absolution will be yours. Any bond, no matter how strained or even severed, will be put to rights.
You again, is it? The recusants sent a lackey. Can you believe they invited me to join them? Now, after what they did? I can scarcely believe it myself. Did they think me a fool? You might be surprised to learn I took them up on the offer. Then I only had to ask. The location of the recusant hideout. It's on Mount Gelmir, found off the old road that leads west from the town of Windmills. That's where they hide. The manor on the peak. Just you wait, wretched recusants. You'll rue the day you insulted my name by laying hands on Lanya. The tale of House Hoslow is told in blood, after all. It's on Mount Gelmir, found off the old road that leads west from the town of Windmills. That's where they hide. The manor on the peak. Just you wait, wretched recusants. The tale of House Hoslow is told. It's on Mount Gats where they hide. Just you wait. The tale of...
Always good to see you safe. So, what do you need?
This is a black knife print. I can scarcely believe you managed to get your hands on this. You recall our conversation about the Knight of the Black Knives, yes? They say the assassins who carried out the deed were scions of the Eternal City. A group entirely of women, arrayed in armor of silver under cloaks which fooled the eye. The knives they wielded, though, were imparted with the power of the Rune of Death through sinister rite. Please, I beg of you, lend me the knife print for a time. I'd love nothing more than to tease out its secrets. Though only a fragment, a very specific ritual had to be performed to impart the power of the Rune of Death. Traces of the one who performed the rite are sure to remain in the imprint. Half my body has been suffused with death. I'm certain it will help me see. Oh, still need something?
Now. You are so very warm. I heard that you lent a hand to dear Roger. He seemed positively elated. He must be possessed of great mental fortitude. It anchors his will and sustains him, despite his grievous wounds. You truly are a champion to dear Roger and myself too. Then good day to you, my dear.
It's you. Well, what do you make of it? What's happened to this village? I witnessed a sight much the same in my infancy. The oppression of the weak. Murder and pillage unchecked. A waking nightmare made by men. But this time, I'm a woman grown. And though the suffering cannot be undone, I can still mete out justice. Justice to the oppressors. Let the scars I carve remind them. I am Nefeli Lu, warrior. But this time, and though the suffering cannot be undone, justice to the oppressors. Let the scars I carve.
A clue. No secrets lie with me, not a one. Oh, please leave me be.
Wait, then. You're not one of them.
Well, what a relief. Oh, goodness me. I am Albus. An Albinoric. As you can see, we're finished. The whole village is finished. The curse mongers have destroyed everything. No one that remains has their wits about them. I beg you. Would you look after this medallion? You must keep it out of the curse mongers' hands. And if you should need the young Albinoric Latena, then please give it to her. A chosen land awaits us, Albinorics. The medallion is the key that leads to the city. It's only a quaint treasure for we who cannot make the journey. But for dear Latena, it is needed to fulfill her purpose. My legs will soon fade, and with them my life. Alas, this is the immovable fate of all Albinorics.